Besides, I don't know whether you still remember, I hope you do, Jürgen Habermas, a great political scientist, philosopher, sociologist in Germany, wrote a book called Legitimation Crisis, and he pointed out there, and quite rightly so, that state is capitalist not when it serves just one class capitalist and neglects interests of all the others, but state is capitalist if its major function consists in bringing together capital and labor. Capital and labor. When they are meeting, capital buys labor, and labor sells itself to capital. Okay, but in order to do that, to that to happen, capital needs to be able to afford the price of the labor, and labor must be attractive enough, in good shape, in good form, well fed, you know, well dressed, well educated, to be wanted by capital. And that's exactly what a capitalist state did when Jürgen Habermas wrote his book. And he called it the Legitimation Crisis because he thought that this sort of bringing together capital and labor is the legitimation of the capitalist state. I suggest to you, ladies and gentlemen, that you change as well, that what is the function of the capitalist state today in the era of consumerism, in the era of liquid modernity, is bringing together the seller and the buyer. Seller and the client, bringing what actually constitutes the content of GNP, you know, the act of money changing place, things being bought. If that happens, everything is okay. The state performs its function. Consumerism goes up. There is ample offer of credit until, you know, credit corrupts, strikes as it did before. So everybody has enough money to obtain what they want, and on the other hand, the producer can sell as much as they want. I think that if Jürgen Habermas was writing again the second edition of the Legitimation Crisis, he would probably select the recent credit collapse as the document that it is so much changing. Now, the most important point was this change since Marx. I don't know whether most, I don't want to compare, but also important, is the new role which doesn't figure, only marginally figures in Marx's analysis, namely the greatest threat which people are afraid of today, namely the threat of exclusion. Exclusion. Exclusion, loss of dignity, loss of function in society, and resulting humiliation. Ignorance and impotence are the nightmares of contemporary people threatened by the turbulent, changing, unpredictable, misty conditions in which we live. Take into account that in our era, the idea of underclass was invented, underclass, which never existed before. Underclass is not like lower class or working class or whatever. Not, it does not simply mean people who are at the bottom of social hierarchy, but if they are at the bottom of hierarchy, bottom of the ladder, then there is a ladder which sooner or later they may climb, right? Underclass means being outside the system. Redundancy is not the same as the original unemployment. Unemployment, this prefix, un, suggested right away from the first sound, suggested that it is abnormality. Unemployment is departure from a norm, but norm is employment. Redundant is irrevocable. There is no reference to anything else. If you are redundant, you are redundant, and goodbye. And that's the only thing which could be on this topic. And that's a new fear. That's a new fear which doesn't take place in Marxist analysis. So if you rightly charge me with the sin of not mentioning Karl Marx, I would say that Karl Marx will be charged for not being prophet enough to see what is happening in the 21st century.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to thank you and sorry for even being so rude vis-a-vis your very good remarks and questions. I was just afraid that we were simply unable to pick up questions and to make them articulate and understandable enough to allow professor to answer them. But in any case, I think that the comments were made as if to say that each of your comments and questions was accepted as a very important remark. And at this point, I would like to thank Professor Zygmunt Bauman for having created this, I would say, a little miracle of intellectual performance, 2 hours past as if 15 minutes. I would like to thank you from the bottom of my heart, thanking director of the Government Museum and Toleration Center, Mr. Vargas Ingeris, for hosting the event. I would like to thank all of you, and I would like to remind you, those who can make it to Kaunas tomorrow at 11 o'clock at the Tautos Mountains University, there is another lecture by Zygmunt Bauman, The Natural History of Evil. Now I would like to thank Mr. Bauman. Thank you very much.